with me now. Walk away. What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to the Truckin Journey. I'm Trucker Jim, and it is Sunday, so you know what that means. Trucker Jim's gonna have a good week. Always works out that way when you start on Sunday. Last week, which is actually, technically, still this week, I'm at like 2,000 miles. So, I'm getting ready to head to Columbia, and then to Newberry, and then to Danville, Virginia. Not going to Louisville today. So hopefully between now and midnight, I can log 500 paid miles or so and hit my little mileage bonus. Had a really good weekend. Did not do a lot of recording, but I did get a little bit. So while I'm packing everything up in the truck, I'm gonna share with you my mom's beautiful yard and garden. She has such a green thumb. And then I'm gonna show you some really awesome classic cars. It was from a car show at the Spring Festival. And then I'm gonna show you a crazy guy who juggles. Thank you. All right, and that does it for our little weekend flashback. If you have a favorite flower, tree, or plant from Mama's house, or a favorite car in the car show, or maybe the juggler was your favorite. If so, let us know in the comments. But guys, it's time to get back trucking. We are at the Columbia Yard. Just did a quick T-call. Now I'm hooked to an empty trailer that I'm taking to Newberry, which will take me to Danville, Virginia. I will be able to finish that today, so yay. I'm not sure what my load is after that. It would be pretty cool if that, it's kind of like a drop yard in Danville. It's something to do with Goodyear. What I'm taking from Newberry is a kiss wire load, which is this like heavy wire. Well, it's not a heavy wire, it's a very thin wire. It goes in tires, but there's a bunch of it and it's a heavy load. But it wouldn't make me mad if I'm shut down in time with a good internet signal by 9 o'clock, because you know what tonight is, right? Well, as far as at the time of this recording, I'm not sure at the time of your watching, but it's Game of Thrones, Season 8, Episode 4. This is the one after the long night, the Battle of the Dead, when Arya sprung out of nowhere to kill the Night King at the end. Spoiler alert if you didn't know that already. Well, I guess that wasn't exactly a spoiler alert. But anyway, it's the episode after that, which should be very interesting. So it's time to get back trucking. Made it to Kiss Wire. Dropped my empty, hooked up to my load.
A new message has arrived.
And now we're headed to Kissy Wire. But first, let's check our message.
I don't like getting these invalid trailer messages, especially when they come in blurry.
All right, everyone. Welcome back. It is now Monday. It's officially a new week, but I am coming to you from Virginia. I think I'm in like Ringgold, Virginia. There's an IKEA DC here. Getting ready to go grab a load that's Atlanta bound, baby. So, how about let's get this day started and get back trucking. All right, I've got my paperwork. This is a pretty heavy load of IKEA furniture, I guess, or something wood, because it's 44,000 pounds, which that means I need to weigh it. But the good news is there's a scale here. I can't remember exactly how this one works, but I know it starts with me driving on it. not real sure of the purpose of that scale because I have no idea what my weights are. So what that means is I gotta go buy a cat scale and weigh this. You guys don't wanna see that, do you? I've done showed it like at least 5 times in previous videos. So we're not going to the cat scale, we're going to Atlanta. So the next time I see you guys, either something pretty interesting is gonna be happening, or we're gonna be at the Kia in Atlanta, which is where we'll wrap this up. And maybe there'll be some words of wisdom to share, or I don't know, some thoughts of Jim anyway. See you guys in the South.
Welcome to Atlanta where the players play and we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
Welcome to Atlanta where the players play and we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
Alright YouTube, we have made it to the IKEA in downtown Atlanta. And since I'm here, and I've got a moment, I wanted to show you guys something. This is notoriously a tough place to park. For a couple of reasons. Number one, it's slanted, like you're at the Petro or a TA or something. Me personally, like straight lines, man, I'm like a laser with it. I'll pop it in there. But when the angle's different, your approach has to be different. Because remember, setup is the key to proper backing.
You know, if you got enough room to pull up, you can get into any spot. But here,
it's kind of tight. You probably want a little more room than what's right there without, you know, being up on the curb. And well, just the other side of the curb, there's little trees. You don't want to make contact with those either.
Hey.
Here's where I'm gonna be putting my trailer. Indoor 4. So, I've got all of, now, you know, on a standard setup, you know, I would be, you know, across from the lines. Well, this isn't a standard setup. These are docks, it's slanted. So I'm actually gonna use as much of this room as I can without hitting anything, dig into this here, and then set up something that sort of resembles a 45, but not exactly, because I would hit the curb over here if I did that. So with my trailer bent at somewhat of a 45 degree angle, I'm gonna need to take my tractor into this space, probably about right in here, and try to make the turn with just grazing the curb, like not touching it, but you couldn't get a credit card in there, you know what I mean? So you guys got two choices. You can stand over here at the pole,
or you can be at this pole.
I think this is gonna be the better angle.
We'll be right back.
All right, that is getting it done right there, people. But we're gonna go ahead and wrap this episode up. I'm gonna run in here and hopefully get my bills. I do hope this load goes smoother than it did last week. This is going to Coca-Cola in Savannah. And last week the bills weren't here. But you know, by the time I got there, dispatch had emailed them the bills, so that wasn't a problem. There was a pallet that had turned over. You know, it's sealed when I get it, so I never get to inspect until I get there. You know, a lot of the old time truckers I hear complain sometimes about technology. Me personally, I'm a fan. Like having an ID badge instead of keeping up with a bunch of keys. That's a good thing. And getting this pickup number off my phone instead of having to bring my notebook in here is a good thing. And boom, it's right where it's supposed to be. For you GMP guys, there's a couple of showers here. It's hit and miss on the towels. Most of the time they'll have them, except for, well, sometimes they don't. So now, I will just do my loaded macro and get on the road and shut down somewhere between here and Savannah, which is where this is going. But I want to thank all of you for taking the time to make it to the end of this video. That's awesome. If you like the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hadn't finished editing yet, but I think there may be some backing in it. And I know you guys like backing in videos. All right, everyone, that's gonna be a wrap. I'll see you in the next episode, but until then, please be safe out there and keep on trucking. Everybody going through a little